Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Santino Maria.
Hey, look at this. Proper English gentleman. Santino and Kozlov.
I can dig it. I like it.
Well, folks, 2 weeks ago on Raw, Santino beat Sheamus thanks to a John Morrison distraction. Last week, Sheamus wanted Santino again. Instead, he got Vladimir Kozlov. After that, though, Sheamus would look for revenge.
Santino doing everything in his power to stay away from Sheamus. Sheamus would have none of it, but John Morrison once again intervening in this situation. Morrison would once again get the best of Sheamus.
I'm still trying to figure out why in the world John Morrison would try to make Sheamus angry. They look like Laurel and Hardy.
Who?
Good evening, Manchester! As you can see, me and my friend Vladimir Kozlov, we like to blend in everywhere we go. And coming here to the UK, we were very, very excited. And we started studying British culture 3 weeks ago. We watched all the James Bond movies, the Austin Powers, Mr. Bean, Benny Hill. And now I think we pretty much know everything about the culture. But the only thing is, every time I cross the road, I almost get killed. I look this way, but the car comes this way. Tomorrow morning, everybody, just for me, please, drive on the other side. It's so easy. It's a...
I can't believe they're actually cheering this stuff.
Speaking of almost get a kill, the reason I have this today is because I want to make a peace, make a friend, bury the hatchet with a superstar from Irish land. That's right. I'm talking about the Sheamus. And he was very angry to me, so we're going to sit down on old-fashioned classic-style tea party, and everything's going to be okay, I'm pretty sure. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guest, Sheamus.
It's a shame for fame.
Well, my question is I wonder if Sheamus has ever been to a tea party before.
Why don't you get up and go ask Sheamus that question?
Hey, Sheamus and I are buddies.
Yeah, okay.
This tea time has international flavor here tonight. You've got
international instant written all over.
You've got Santino, who's an Italian. Vladimir Kozlov is Russian.
Well, Vladimir Kozlov is actually American. He has an American.
Sheamus is Irish, and we're in the United Kingdom. And this is Monday Night Raw, and we are live tonight for tea time with Santino. I'm glad Sheamus dressed for the occasion.
Hi, Sheamus. Please have a seat. Welcome to my tea party. I love parties. First of all, I feel that you and I, we got off to the wrong foot, and I want to be on the right foot. So we are going to have a tea party. Now we have green tea, we have ginger tea. Sorry. But we also have an autographed picture of Mr. T.
You know what, Santino? I think I got you all wrong. I mean, you're not a bad fella. I think you're just misunderstood.
You see?
You know, it's funny. I knew a fella just like you back home in Ireland. And just like you, he only had one friend. And that friend was a donkey.
Lucky.
Funny thing about this fella was, well, he was, well, let's just say everyone in the town called him the village idiot.
You see that? That bothers me so much. How could these people call a donkey the village idiot? It's a donkey. You know, maybe these people should lower their expectations from a donkey. Anyway, you know what? I think it's time for some tea.
Kozlov's the best
now,
part.
Now, do you take your tea dark or milky? Oh. No. I am not trying to be smart at all. Apologize. I'm not referring when I say milky to the fact that you have no pigmentation. I'm not. No, people, you're not helping. Don't make him anger, please. I don't like it when he's anger. You know what? Speaking of anger, Seamus, you must admit you have some rage and anger inside you. And I did some research studying some psychology. And I found out that there's only one of two reasons why you could have such rage inside you. The first reason is that you have been overexposed to gamma rays. The second reason is that probably when you were growing up, you were excluded from activities with the other kids because you're a ginger.
No. I'm not. Oh, you're very generous people, but you're not really helping me right now. I'm not that person, Seamus. I'm not going to exclude you from activities and fun. Look, I invited you to my party. This is our party. It's not just your party. I'm not going to treat you like you're a ghost. Oh. No. Come on, that's not funny. Everyone knows that ghosts are not this white. Come on. No.
You're a very funny fella, aren't you, Santino, huh? I'll tell you what, you and me laughing so hard. I forget why I hate you in the first place.
Exactly. I think that you and I have the potential to get along famously, Seamus. You know, I can't remember why you hate me either.
Seamus hates you because you beat him.
I don't know what he's talking about.
Yes, you did. You beat Seamus. It was the biggest upset in WWE history.
Ever. Thank you. Thank you very much, Kozlov. Your memory is so good.
A Kozlov chant! Oh, my!
Only in the United Kingdom.
You know what? You're low on tea.
I don't like the way you're looking at me. Here's some tea here. Hold the cup, please. I'm sorry, can you? I'm sorry. No. That was. I'm so sorry. Seamus! Seamus!
Can I have your attention, please? I received another email from the Raw General Manager. And I quote, "The time for tea and crumpets has come to an end. It's now time for action. Clear the ring. And clear Vladimir Kozlov from ringside as well. Because Santino Marella is going one-on-one with Seamus."
Well, look at Seamus.
if Santino and Sheamus might become friends. That's not the case. They will go one-on-one next live on Monday Night Raw.
We are back on Monday Night Raw, and folks, you're not going to want to miss this train wreck. Sheamus versus Santino, impromptu matchup ordered by our general manager just moments ago after Santino spilled an entire teapot into the lap of Sheamus.
And throughout the commercial break, Sheamus was pleading with the official to not let this match happen. Santino wants nothing to do with Sheamus. And why does Santino have his ring gear on underneath his suit?
Well, because that's what all superstars do. They walk around with their ring gear underneath their clothes.
I didn't know that. Did Santino shriek like a girl?
Well, he's trying to call timeout, too. Santino owns a victory over Sheamus, which started this whole thing, thanks to John Morrison.
And that, to me, you might think that Santino would be more confident heading into this match against Sheamus. The fact that Santino owns a victory over Sheamus.
He only won because John Morrison distracted Sheamus.
Well, you see it that way, Cole. Some people may think that Santino was going to win that match regardless.
Those people are idiots.
Okay.
Sheamus trying to get his hands on Santino, who has no interest in getting into this matchup, and Santino running away like a girl.
Get away! Oh man! I'm not ready, man. Just warm up. No smacking.
And I quote, Santino Marella, you have two choices. Get back in the ring and compete, or be immediately suspended.
Santino, you might want to ask how long the suspension would be and perhaps take the suspension as opposed to get in the ring with an angry Sheamus.
Now Santino trying to psych himself up. General manager's been busy tonight. Oh man, the Cobra dissected. The Cobra was just run over by Sheamus. Oh my Lord, Sheamus flattened Santino. You can feel that impact out here at ringside.
Yeah, it has been a night for taking out aggression, and Sheamus is taking some out on Santino right now.
Come on, man. Let's just stop for a second. For 1 second.
Well, a blatant low blow.
What are you doing?
And Santino's been disqualified, and now the celebration started. This guy's a fool. And you know what? Well, I guess he's celebrating because he didn't get killed.
I mean, you might want to think about getting out of here.
He just said it's so easy for him. Santino. You might want to wake up. Boom kick. Santino was just sent back across the pond. And this is not going to be good. Sheamus is done playing games with this goof. Well, folks. The Irish curse is about to be felt by Santino. And John Morrison, again?
I don't know what you see wrong with this, Cole. You always say, step up. Don't worry about what other people say about you. Don't worry about what other people think. And John Morrison is doing that right now.
Flash kick to the jaw. Hey, I'm all for stepping up.
And that's what John Morrison's doing.
But if you're going to pick your spot, why would you pick it against a guy like Sheamus? John Morrison continues his attacks on Sheamus as he continues to bail Santino out of trouble. John Morrison making a statement again here tonight on Monday Night Raw, but the question still is why? Why Sheamus? Why pick on that Celtic warrior?
I don't understand how you can paint Sheamus as the victim in this whole situation.
He is. He's been ambushed 3 weeks in a row.